in group settings, what we are trying to achieve is to unpack these emotions, how they are being constructed and where they come from. The guilt is about when we think, depending on our value systems, that we do something wrong or we didn't do that which is wrong. No? And it's about the action. It's about doing something or not doing something. And because of the context, the wider context tells us this is wrong or right. No? And the shame is about our identities, how we feel about ourselves in different contexts, like the society tells us, like being lazy is not good, you know, you have to work because capitalism tends to say, you know, we constantly produce and compete and be successful. So if you are not in that, you know, environment as being, you know, not attracted to do something, you feel shame because, you know, maybe you identify yourself, okay, I'm not very, you know, productive person. So it brings you a shame if you are not producing something. And in identities that are, you know, especially marginalized, many people grab that, you know, context that the social values, norms telling us that I am not good, I am not fitting in the society. So unpacking these emotions is very important for active participation in group processes and to around the brave space, how we stop, how we are scared of doing mistakes, you know, because of this success and perfectionist, you know, ideas that the society is constantly putting on us. So what we propose here to also bring another, you know, emotion, which is called remorse, which is different than a bit of guilt. Is about remorse is more our own internal value system tells us what is right and wrong, but remorse is not as strong as guilt. It gives an agency to change something. If we did something wrong, we are more aware of it and we can do better next time.
So you will become bamboo.
Remorse, on the other side, is a more conscious sense.
Does that make sense to you all?
Yeah. The guilt zone or the remorse zone? Because these are the emotions of
guilty.